I'm a sister. My name is Sumaya from Dhaka, Bangladesh. Why do women need to cover up their fasting or make up for their fasting, which is obligatory after Ramadan, while they do not need to pray their missed prayers during menstrual process? If they need to keep the obligatory missed fasting before the next Ramadan, can't they any longer fast afterward, like covering up after 2 to 3 years missed fast? So basic question is that when the Muslimah, when they miss their salah during menstruation, they don't have to catch up or do not have to compensate, do not have to pray for the salah they have missed. But if they miss the fast during Ramadan, which is the Fard fast, they have to make up for it. The reason is that there's a difference between salah as one of the pillars of Islam as compared to fasting. Salah is a pillar of Islam that every adult Muslim, he has to pray Salah. And if he's a man, irrespective whether he's sick or healthy, he should pray Salah. If he can't go to the mosque and if he's sick, he should pray at home. If he cannot stand and pray, he should lie down and pray. If he cannot lie down and pray, he has to sit and pray. There's no excuse. For the woman, if they're having menstrual cycle, then they're excused. And if they're postnatal, then they may have to miss. But this salah which they miss, they don't have to compensate. Why? The reason is that salah is an act, it's a fard which is done 5 times a day. If you miss it for any reason, and if you're told to fast later on, suppose 7 days you miss it, then if you have to pray again, it would be double what you're praying every day 5 times, besides the sunnah, etc. And again you pray additional. As compared, let me give you an example, that if you are hungry and maybe you could not eat for 7 days, that doesn't mean that once you start getting food, you'll start eating double every day to compensate. Yes, you may eat a little bit more, that's it. That doesn't mean you keep on eating double. Instead of 3 meals a day, you have 6 meals a day for the next 7 days. So this, because it's a fard and every day you have to do it, so during normal days it will be an additional double burden. So it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving concession. So it's leniency to the woman that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven them and say you need not pray and you need not compensate later on. In comparison to fasting. Fasting, as I say, somewhat like overhauling of the human body. Like, you know, when you have a machine or maybe a car, certain machine require overhauling once in 6 months, sometimes once a year. Similarly, when you have a car. So these machines, if you allow me to call a human being a machine, then human being is the most complicated machine on the face of the earth. Don't you think it requires overhauling or a servicing? So this Ramadan is a servicing of the human body once a year for 1 month. Now imagine, suppose they're doing servicing of a car once a year or once in 6 months, and if you forget and you delay by 1 month, you cannot say, okay, now I did not service, I was supposed to service every January, next January came and I forgot, so I'll wait for next January. No, the moment you have a chance to service it, you do it. If you couldn't do it in January, do it in February. If you can't do it in February, do it in March. The earlier the better. Similarly, because you could not fast while you are menstruating, the earliest, the moment that menstruation is over, you start fasting, you continue fasting. If it is Ramadan, you continue. Once Ramadan is over, you compensate for the fast you missed, so that your overhauling of the body, your servicing of the body is completed. The benefit that you get from the fasting is completed, the medical benefits which you can discuss in detail later on, and the various spiritual benefits, which is only once in a year, once a month. So to you not to miss, for the lady not to miss all these benefits, whether it be medical benefits, spiritual benefits, the blessings and the forgiveness that Allah gives, it is required that you compensate for the fast, preferably before the coming of next Ramadan. The earlier the better. Do it in Shawwal. If not in Shawwal, the next month. But preferably before next Ramadan. But for any reason, if you are sick for a very long time, and if you could not compensate or make up for the fast you have missed one in the full year, you can surely make it up the next year, but don't delay it. Faster the better. And that's the reason fasting has to be compensated, in which the salah does not have to be compensated.